Welcome to my channel Master Mathematics by Shaiji Mohandas. Today we are looking about the ratio and proportion. It is very useful to all competitive examinations like SSC, RRB or CBA examination, and also useful in the 8th class students also. So let us see what are the basic things about ratio and proportion. Okay, if ratio means if any two quantities are in ratio, that means we can written as A is to B, or otherwise we can write it as A by B. If any two quantities are in ratio A is to B, then it can be written also in A by B form. Okay, from that we can write what is the inverse of this ratio. If X is to Y is a ratio, what is the inverse ratio? Which is nothing but Y is to X. This is the inverse ratio. Okay, if any ratio can be multiplied with non-zero numbers or divided with any non-zero numbers, means there is no change in that ratio. For example, if A is to B are in ratio, you have to multiply a non-zero number with m, then the ratios will be AM is to BM, but there is no change in that ratio. Okay, for example, another thing, if you multiply or divide any number with this ratio, there is no change, it remains same. That means X is to Y is a ratio is divided by N, a non-zero number. X by N equal to Y by N. It has also same. There is no change. It remains same the ratios. Okay. From the ratios A by B and C by D and E by F are in the ratio. A by B, C by D, E by F are in the ratio. What is the compound ratio? How to find this compound ratio? Means it is easy. Nothing but we can write it as the compound ratio is. Compound ratio is nothing but A into C into E by B into D into F, which is nothing but the multiply with the numerator and whole divided by the product of the denominator. Okay, so this is the compound ratio. Next, if A is to B are in the ratio, then we can write it as the duplicate ratio. What is a duplicate ratio? This duplicate ratio will be nothing but A square is to B square. This is the duplicate ratio. Okay. Before going in depth of the problem, you have to understand the basic things about the ratio and proportion. If we are doing the problem, that time I will give some tips and tricks to that solving problems. Okay, in your competitive examinations, so lots of problem will ask in this portion, so you have to carefully watch this entire video. So then next, sub duplicate ratio. What is a sub duplicate ratio? Which is nothing but that is square root of A is to square root of B. What is the triplicate ratio? Which is also same, nothing but here triplicate ratio will be A cube is to B cube, and nothing but sub triplicate ratio will be, which is nothing but here cube root of A is to cube root of B. So if A and B are the two quantities are in ratio, then the duplicate ratio will be A square is to B square. Sub duplicate ratio will be square root of A is to square root of B. Triplicate means it is A cube is to B cube. That means triplicate. Then sub triplicate is the cube root of A is to cube root of B. If A and B are in ratio, what is the inverse ratio? Inverse ratio is B is to A. If any non-zero number with multiply this ratio or divided with this ratio, means if there is no change, it will be remain same. Okay. Next, if A comma B comma C are in continuous proportion, if A comma B comma C are in continuous proportion, then we can write it as A by B equal to B by C. That means we can write it as B square is equal to AC. B square is equal to AC, nothing but B equal to square root of AC. Here B is called the mean proportion. Mean proportion. B is called the mean proportion, and C is called the third proportion. C is called third proportion. So A, B, C are in continuous proportion. We can write it as A by B is equal to b by c, which is nothing but b square is equal to ac. B is called as mean proportion and c is called as third proportion. If any given ratios 1, 2, 3 are in ratio, means you have to find the mean proportion. Or otherwise we can ask 1x is to 3, what is the mean proportion? That means b is x. Nothing but we can write it as x is equal to, what is x? X is equal to square root of ac, which is nothing but 1 into 3, that is equal to square root of 3 is the mean proportion. Okay. Next, what is mean by a proportion? A is to B and C is to D are in proportion, means we can write it as A is to B proportion, C is to D. So in case of proportion, A and B are in ratio and C and D are in proportion. A and B and C and D are in proportion. We can write it as A is to B proportion to C is to D. From that, A is to B proportion to C is to D means this is called as a middle term. This is called as a middle term. And A and D are extremes. A and D are extremes. Okay. So A, B, C and D are in proportion means A is to B proportion to C is to D. That means B, C is called the middle terms. And A and D are called extremes. From that we can write it as product of middle terms, product of middle terms equal to the product of extremes, product of extremes. If any four numbers are in proportion means, which is nothing but here, product of middle terms is equal to product of extremes, which is nothing but here AD equal to BC, AD equal to BC is the formula, okay. So from this, these are the basic things about ratio and proportion. We are going in depth of problem. That time I will show you some tricks and tips. So you have to make sure to watch the entire video. So you have to understand it with the couple of examples. Let us see how to do. They given the examples are, if A is to B equal to 5 is to 9 and B is to C equal to 4 is to 7, find A is to B is to C, which is nothing but here A, B, C. We have to find A, B, C. That means you have to write the values here. 5, 9, next 4, 7. From here, what is the C here? This is nearer to B. That means you can write the value of B here, 9. Same way, in the B is 4. Nothing but here is nearer to B. That means here this 4 is written here. So then you have to multiply this. That is 20, 36, 63. So A, B, C are in ratio. A is to B is to C equal to 20 is to 36 is to 63. This is the ratio. Okay. It is very simple to find the ratios. From the second question, first part is find the third proportion to 16 and 36. Given two values, 16 and 36, find the third proportion, which is nothing but to find the third proportion A, B and C. From given A, B, C are in the ratio, you have to find the third proportion. Means here we can write it as A is to B proportion to B is to C. This is the third proportion formula. So from here A is to B is written here 16 is to 36. Nothing but here A is to B equal to here 16 is to 36 is to 36 is to C, which is nothing but you can write it as here C equal to 36 into 36 divided by 16. Let us solve this. 4, 9, again 4, 9, that is 81 is the third proportion. What is the third proportion? Third proportion is, which is nothing but 81. Okay. Second one, what is the fourth proportion? What is mean by a fourth proportion? In that fourth proportion means A is to B is to C is to D. So from here, D is the fourth proportion. That means we can write it as 4 is to 9 proportion to 12 is to D. So what is the fourth proportion? Fourth proportion is very easy to find here. So D is equal to here 9 into 12 by 4, which is nothing but 3. That is 27 is the fourth proportion, so which is very easy. So fourth proportion is 27. Okay, the third one is mean proportion between 0.08 and 0.18. Here we have to find the mean proportion, which is nothing but A, B, C are in proportion. The mean proportion is will be written B equal to square root of AC. We already discussed. That means here this is A and this is C. That means here we have to find this mean proportion B equal to 0.08 into 0.18, which is nothing but these are decimals. You have to write in the fraction form, which is nothing but here. We can write in a 2 decimals means 8 by 100 into here. Again 2 decimals 18 by 100. Which is nothing but we can write in the form of 8 into 18 divided by 10,000. That is 18 into 8 is equal to here. Square root of 144 divided by 10,000. Which is nothing but what is the square root of 144? That is 12. So 12 divided by what is the square root of 10,000? It is nothing but here 100. So the mean proportion will be 0.12. It is very easy if you once understand the concept about ratio and proportion. Okay. So I hope you all understood these all problems. If you have any doubts or suggestion, please comment on the comment box. Okay. So next video is based on more in-depth problems of this ratio and proportion. So keep watching on my channel. Okay, so if it is useful in this video, means you have to like and share to your friends also. You haven't subscribed my channel yet, please subscribe and hit the bell icon on the right side, then only you will get more notification from my channel. So thank you so much for watching. See you soon on my next video. Till then, bye.